The time is just after 11:30 on this Saturday morning. It's the 13th of August. It is a beautiful day around the Northwest. Whatever you're doing, enjoy the good weather because God knows when we're going to get it again. And whatever you're doing, do it safely as well. All right, for all you movie buffs out there, I'm glad to say, finally, we are joined by the one and only Mr. Collie Mac Pháidín, who's going to talk us through all the latest comings and goings in the world of movies and cinema. And what's coming up over the next month or so. Collie, good morning.
Good morning. It's great to be back on. I know we're slightly out of sync, but, you know, it's all worth it that I'm finally here. Even though, as you said, we mentioned the elephant in the room straight away. She said, the weather is beautiful.
Yeah.
Nobody's going to the cinema, at least during the daytime at the moment. But as the weather forecast on the Highland Radio said, it's going to end soon enough, so enjoy it while you can.
Come Monday, theaters will be full again.
Yeah, we'll be packed. So we're going to give you some tips about what you can look forward to. Because there's always, you know, every cloud has a silver lining, or in this case, a silver screen.
Exactly. And there is, in spite of the good weather, there is plenty on offer at the cinema at the moment.
Well, it's noticeable that, you know, because the weather is good, but the evening shows are still going very well. And I think that's because of the quality of particularly, you know, grown-up films. And one that we talked about a lot last time we were on at the start of July was Where the Crawdads Sing. And we were saying that, really anticipating it. If you remember, I actually went and bought the book because we were talking about it so much. It just happens to be here. And just after we went off air, I did something I never do. I read the reviews before the movie came out. I usually don't do that.
Right.
And they absolutely slated at Rory. And I was going, oh God, I was on our Highland Radio telling everyone how great this would be. But you know what? People have loved it, Rory. It's absolutely jam-packed. People who've read the book and people who haven't read the book have really enjoyed it. So it just goes to show you that, you know, maybe if you're someone who watches 10 movies every week, your tastes are very different to people who just go the odd time and for a beloved book. So Where the Crawdads Sing, we talked about last time, and it has turned out to be a really successful story about a girl who has to raise herself in the swamp. Mm. But I really thought maybe the people who love the book wouldn't like it at all. But it turns out everyone loves it. So that's still going strong.
What's the verdict? Book better than the film?
I feel the book is always better than film. And because it's a book about somebody being on their own, that's easier to do in a book, because in a movie, they have to say it out loud. Gee, I'm awful isolated. And that sounds corny. But aside from that, and it's Daisy Edgar-Jones, who we know from Normal People, practically Irish.
Yes,
She's absolutely brilliant in it. So that's really good. The other one we talked about that hadn't come out, that has come out since, is Bullet Train. Now, I love the fact that we've these really clever, smart movies like Elvis and Top Gun and full of action, but also very smart. And we're going to talk about a really weird movie, Nope, in a few minutes. But one of the things I loved about Bullet Train, summer should also be about dumb fun. And this is dumb as nuts, but I actually really enjoyed it. Like, it's people quoting philosophy while beating seven levels of tar out of each other on a Japanese bullet train while dressed up as Japanese mascots. Plot? Yeah, it's not really important. What it is about Brad Pitt looking cool and fighting people. And it's one of those things, you know, you see some people going into it and you go, you're not going to enjoy this. And then you see other people going in and you go, you're going to have the time of your life. So if anyone just wants, like, it's been a long couple of years.
Yeah.
We all had, both lockdown brain, COVID brain and so on. If you wanted to leave your brain at home and go to a movie, I would recommend Bullet Train. It's very warm. Leave the brain in the fridge. You won't need it at all to watch this movie, but it's just action packed. And like, it is very violent, but in a cartoon way, a bit like John Wick meets Snatch. But probably not as good as either of those movies, but it's a summer dumb blockbuster. I had a really good time. Again, critics didn't like it at all, but I just thought it was good, dumb, silly fun.
Well, let's have a listen and see what's in store for us with Bullet Train. Here's a clip.
I am ready.
No more sociopaths. No more maniacs.
You put peace out in the world, you get peace back.
I think you might be forgetting what you do for a living.
Do you have anything sparkling?
Domo de God.
Sure you want to talk this out?
No.
Okay. Between us sits a wall.
A negative outlook leads to a negative outcome.
Do you think there was a little head trauma?
Maybe.
Bullet Train. Exclusively in cinemas.
Yeah, so you can even hear from the trailer, even without the visuals, exactly what you're what's in store for you.
You hear the way talking, you hear there. Yeah. Some people will recognize very famous female voice there. Did you know who that was?
No.
Well, I don't want to reveal it, but there's loads of cameos here in this movie. Loads of people turn up for 15 seconds. You go, oh, look at them. So it's that sort of fun, silly movie. Brad Pitt's having the time of his life. He just is enjoying it. And, you know, he just looks so cool and great. You know, and you're kind of going, how old is he? Oh, my God. You know, but it's great fun. Not for everyone. It is dumb. It is silly. And as I said, that sort of cartoony violence. But
yeah.
I think some people will enjoy it over
Brad Pitt's probably at the stage of his career as well where he doesn't have to be picky about the scripts he chooses anymore. So he can just decide, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to do this because I like it. I enjoy it. It's a bit of fun.
Exactly. There's a famous story about, I think it was Jaws 4. Michael Caine was sent the script and he was thinking, I'm not going to do that. And he opened the script and said, it opens up in the Bahamas. And he said, I'll do it. And I have a feeling Brad Pitt kind of went, yeah, load of my friends in Japan running around. Yeah, why not? That's why not? Fun.
Nothing
yeah.
better to do.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right. So that's Bullet Train. That's in cinemas now at the moment.
That's in cinemas now. Also in cinemas now, I'd like to talk about Nope. And I said Bullet Train would be a bit divisive. Now we're talking divisive.
Yeah. So this is one actually I saw. I spotted the trailer for it. There's TV spots running for it left, right, and center now. I spotted it. It immediately grabbed my attention.
Yes, I was one of the big Super Bowl ads. And it's by a guy called Jordan Peele, who made his name as a comedian and then has made a couple of horror movies called Get Out and Us, which are really different, you know, specializing in the sort of, I suppose, the Black American experience with horror and so on. And just a different tale. And one of the things I love about him, he was offered truckloads of money to make sequels to them. He's going, nope, pun not intended. I'm going to make my own original stories. And this one, I don't even want to say too much about it because you saw the trailer. It grabbed your attention, but you hadn't a clue what was going on.
No, that's the thing about it. You're looking at it and you're like, okay, I get it. There's a little bit of sci-fi slash fantasy in here.
Yeah.
But that's all you get. Let's have a listen to what's in store for us with Nope.
What did you see?
It's big. They mad.
Nope. In cinemas, August 12th.
That's all you get from it.
Yeah. And even that, you know, there's a lot of directors who have nothing to do with the trailers. I know, without knowing for a fact, Jordan Peele is all over that that trailer because of the use of music, the strangeness, the oddness of it. And like anyone like you and I who love their music as well, going to really enjoy the use of music in this movie. And look, just say, so Daniel Kaluuya, who's fast becoming one of my favorite actors, is a rancher. There are horse wranglers for Hollywood. They give animals to Hollywood and they're kind of being replaced by green screen. You know, instead people are going, it's much cheaper to do a CGI horse than actually hire people to bring in a horse.
Yeah.
So that's, and they're running a ranch and there's something strange going on in the ranch. People will know a little bit, maybe it's something kind of UFO sci-fi, but don't believe everything you've read. And I really enjoyed this. I thought this was, I didn't know what was going to happen. I didn't know where it was going. And then when you kind of find out, you have a choice. You can go, all right, okay, it's weird, but I'll go with it. Or you could be like, a story I often tell about my dear cousin, Mary DeLourdes, who was watching Empire Strikes Back, and she could take it all until they land in a cave that's not a cave. And she goes, no, I don't believe that. And I remember having to say, well, maybe, you know, all the magic space warriors, you could have left it at that. So,
If you're going to watch a movie like Empire Strikes Back or anything of that ilk, you sort of have to suspend.
Yeah, and also, she was about 10 at the time, and I've told that story about 1,000 times, which is deeply unfair.
I'm sure she'll thank you.
She lives in Adelaide. She may be listening. She will beat the life out of me.
So that's no. So that's a definite yep.
And it's a definite yep from me. Although. Okay. Like sort of M. Night Shyamalan, I know we have to move on, but like M. Night Shyamalan with movies like Signs and The Sixth Sense, there are people who are going to come out of this and go, nah, what? Not with that at all. I hate it.
Not for me.
Companion is going to say, no, I totally got it. It's great. It's one of those. You'd be talking about it in the pub afterwards. I really liked it.
Okay, cool. That's Nope. Okay, that's in cinemas now. And what have we got next on the list?
Okay, so coming out next week was something that was a big hit a couple of years ago. It was Fisherman's Friends. And you probably know it. It's one of those movies. I think the Brits do particularly well. Like Calendar Girls and Military Wives. These true stories then with a bit of fiction. So it was all the Cornwall singers who were singing sea shanties that suddenly became hugely popular. People will remember the meme going around about the Weller Man. And they became a big hit. I think maybe they were on Britain's Got Talent or something like that. They could be a big hit. And they made a kind of Hollywood version of the movie, thinking it'd be small. It was a massive hit. So they're back again. We've got Fisherman's Friends too. And, you know, I'd be only mildly interested, but they've added in, you know, I have to stick up for my Dubliners, Imelda May. Imelda May comes in as a pop singer. And, you know, not only is she great, she's a fabulous singer as well. And she can sing all styles of music. And it's the lads, after they have had a bit of fame, like every band, they've plucked from obscurity. They were all fishermen who suddenly got all this fame thrown at them. And they're not really dealing with that well. Now they're with their newfound celebrity. And how are they going to do it? And this is just a nice, fun, I think it's one of those, you bring your daughter and your mum to, you know, one of those enjoyable family movies.
Okay, let's have a listen to what's in store with Fisherman Friends.
Catering passes are allocated at the trader's entrance.
Oh, no, it's Fisherman's Friends are a band.
I thought you were talking about the cough sweets.
What's it like sharing a record label with Lady Gaga?
According to her management, she's well chuffed.
Cheer up, me lads. Let your heart...
The Fisherman's Friends have a new album ready to roll.
Moby Dick and the Whalers are not on message.
All they said was, does she like meat or pasty?
We made the papers.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how bad is it?
11.
With success comes responsibility.
Go on, get out of here.
That's some performance you did yesterday. I've done some crazy things in my time too.
I don't think I'm cut out for being in the spotlight.
The fan club's been inundated with people wanting to be the new Fisherman's Friend.
When father died, the band died with him.
They want you as a new recruit.
No, we bloody don't.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, that's, you know, it's the opposite of the Nope trailer. As intriguing as the Nope trailer was, you're going, what the hell? I think everyone listening to that goes, okay, I know exactly what I meant for you.
It's that
movie, you know, and as I said, I think the Brits make this sort of normal person becomes famous, how they deal with it. They do this one particularly well.
Yeah.
The music's going to be really good, even though, you know, sea shanty's not my thing. Yeah. But when it's sung so well and from such, they put a lot of work into the soundtrack because I was reading about it earlier. And it's just going to be really nice. And kind of maybe an end of the summer before school comes back, before all the stress starts again.
Yes.
You know, a really nice family day out. And that opens next Friday, so the 19th. And it's
going to
run for a while, I think, yeah.
And it's family friendly as well. So as you say, you know, a family day out, a feel-good movie, a feel-good story, one for the whole family.
Absolutely. Yeah, everyone's going to love it. There's a couple of scenes where one of the older fellas, you know, is trying to go to like politically correctness course because stop people calling people darling and so on.
People are going to love it.
It's just funny and sweet and, you know, slightly tongue in cheek, but no offense, no harm to anyone. I think people are going to really enjoy that one. It's not going to change the world, but it's going to be really enjoyable.
Okay, that's great. So that's Fisherman's Friends 2 that is hitting theatres on the 19th of August. Collie, thanks so much for joining us.
When are we back?
We're back next month. Do you know if there's anything, any big movie events coming up over the next couple of months?
A couple of massive ones. A movie called Mrs. Harris Goes to Paris, I think it's going to be really enjoyable.
Okay.
There's an Irish movie called Russia and Frank, I can't wait to see. But most of all, Michael Flatley's Blackbird, the movie they said was never going to be released because it was too bad, is coming out the second movie. The only thing that, look, it'll either be brilliant or it'll be rubbish. Either way, I will love it.
And people will flock to see it just to see Michael Flatley. Does he fall flat on his backside or does he?
Exactly. The only thing that could be disappointing is if it was all right. Either be great or be rubbish. We're going to enjoy it. As they said,
you don't want any middle ground with this one.
Yeah. The fella who scares the bejesus out of Joey from Friends has finally made his movie. 5 years we've been waiting for this one. It's going to come out. So that's going to be the first on the agenda next month, Rory. I can't wait for it already.
Looking forward to it, Collie. Thanks for joining us. We'll talk to you next month. All right.
Now I
never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.